We're staying in our annotation.dwg file, and you can see that we've got our notes and our bolting plate plan text there. And what we did in the previous video was set up a dimension style to allow us to start adding dimensions to our bolting plate to communicate our design intent. Now, there's a couple of little settings that I want you to set up first before you start dimensioning. So in your layers panel in the home tab on the ribbon, make sure that you place your dimensions on the dimensions layer. It's always good to make sure that the relevant objects are on the relevant layer. Now, have a look at the status bar at the bottom of the screen. Can you see it says 1:1 there? And if you click on that little flyout arrow, there's all these different scales available to you. Now, this particular scale that we're looking at is your annotation scale in the model space. I want you to leave it set as 1:1. Now, there's a reason for that, and you'll find out more about that in the next chapter, the chapter that talks about setting up things like title blocks and scaled viewports and so on. Now, the reason that I'm deliberately leaving the annotation scale at 1:1 is so that you can see why that annotation scale is there. So let's start dimensioning now. Now, you can dimension off of the annotation panel here on the home tab on the ribbon, or you can go to the annotate tab on the ribbon like so, and there's our dimensions panel there. Now, I prefer to dimension off of the annotate tab on the ribbon. The reason being, there's a really nice little layer override. Can you see it says use current layer? So if you've forgotten in the home tab to go to dimensions here, in the annotate tab, you can go, hey, I want the dimensions layer. So you can override the current layer, even if it isn't the dimensions layer. Very useful. Also, you can select your style, which is training, like so as well. Now, dimensioning is very simple off of the annotate tab. You've got all your dimensions here on this flyout here. So you've got linear, aligned, angular, arc length, radius, diameter, jogged, and ordinate. And if I just hit escape there just to lose that menu, I've also got this thing here called automatic dimensioning. It's just called the dim command, the dimension command. And that allows me to automatically dimension objects in AutoCAD. We do cover that a little bit later in the course, though. So we're just going to use this little flyout here. Now, I'm going to go for a linear dimension initially. Make sure that your object snaps are on, otherwise you will not dimension accurately. So I'm going to go endpoint snap there as an origin, endpoint snap there as an origin. When I drag upwards now, you'll see the dimension appear. Drag it up a little bit to about there and click. Now, you'll notice everything looks remarkably small, but if you zoom in real close, you'll see there that there's my 1402.1. So it's 1402 millimeters 0.1. Now you can see that that 0.1, if you're working in millimeters, is kind of inconsequential. So what we can do there is actually edit our dimension style on the fly. I'll click on the arrow here. There's training there. I'll go to modify. I'll go to fit or unit. Either one will work. I'm going to change the precision there to that one. If I go to fit, what I could have done is place the text manually. I could have rounded up the scale. I could have scaled the dimensions to the layout. There's lots of different settings there as well that allow me to tidy up the dimensions. So I'll okay that, and then I'll close it, and you'll see that updates to just 1402, like so. So if I now zoom out, you'll see that the arrowheads are there as well. They're right on the end, but they're all just very, very small. And the reason they're very small is our annotation scale here is set to 1:1, which means that these arrowheads and the text and the lines are all 1:1. They're full size in the model tab down here. Now, don't worry about that at the moment. That'll all become a lot more apparent in the next chapter. What I'd like you to do now is place a radius, a diameter, and an angular dimension. So let's do that. Let's go here, we'll go radius, we'll select the left-hand circle, drag the radius up to about there and click. We'll then do a diameter, select the middle circle, drag that up. Now you can line it in with that one if you want to, or you can bring it to a different position. It's entirely up to you, like so. And then we'll do angular, which is just here, and we'll pick two lines. I'll go for that line and just drag the angle out like that. So you can see we've dimensioned up the drawing, but we've dimensioned it in a way where our annotation scale is left at that 1:1 down on the status bar.